Hi, and welcome to MightyCall. My name is Mira, and today I will explain how our system works so that you can use all the features at your best convenience. I hope you are excited, because I am. First of all, in this video, I will cover the following points. How to work with a journal, which is a place where you can keep track of your call history, voicemails, and text. How to work with business context book, which is a mini CRM feature with all the information about your clients. How to add a team member, how to set up the call flow settings, a place where you can manage your calls, business hours, customize greetings, and choose a calling method. How to add more business numbers to your account, local and toll-free, and how to customize your personal settings, such as call forwarding and voicemails. And also, I will add a few words about our mobile app so that you can work from anywhere. Without further ado, let's start. Want to keep track of your customer's communication? Log into your MightyCall account and go to the journal section, where all your clients' requests, such as calls, text, voicemails, are gathered in one place. Filter the journal by activity, such as an inbound voicemail, missed call, or by the agent. You can read all the voicemails and listen to it, or have it sent to your email. Also, you can listen to call recordings here, which are stored in the cloud for 1 year for free. Hence, there is no need to have any additional space in your drive. You will also be able to assign the tasks to your team member. This way, Journal will help you to keep a better track of tasks that are done and tasks that need some attention. Want to save information about your customers and see the history of interactions that your business had with a certain contact? Move to the Business Contacts book, where all the interactions and notes are visible to all the members of the team. It's like a mini CRM, but for a small business. So here, I added all my contacts. If we open Max card, we can see all his information stored in one place. We can also see the call history with them, listen to call recordings, or download it. If you have an existing contact list, you can simply import it. Got a team? Let's add it in the team section. Do it easily by clicking on the Add User button, which will prompt you to enter all the most important information about your user, such as their first and last name, email, forwarding number, and you can even choose an extension for your team member, as well as assign them role of a user or administrator. The difference between these roles is that administrator has more capacities, such as edit the call flow settings, add and delete users, as well as see call history for every user. You can also create group if you have multiple people working in different departments by clicking on Add Group button. Moving on to the call flow section, by clicking on Incoming Calls To, you can choose to which numbers the calls will be distributed. Let's add our local number here. Then, choose if you want to receive calls from all the customers or create VIP and block list. Choose your business hours, set up availability to 24/7, or have customized business hours. Choose the right time zone and specify working hours itself. Do you want your customers to hear personalized greetings? Then you can record it and upload it yourself. By default, it is set to hello and thank you for calling, but you can always change it. Our team could help you record a greeting with Amazon Polly for free. Just send us your script. Choose how you and your team want to receive calls. Change it by clicking on the Customize button and choose from 9 different options. You can add an IVR, in other words, voice menu, like press 1 for sales, press 2 for support, and set special call routing rules for your team. Let's see how it works. So here, we set an IVR and choose where the call is routed. If your customer presses 1, they will be forwarded to sales team. If they press 2, they will be forwarded to user Peter, who is responsible for support. If your customer decided not to press anything, they will automatically be forwarded to leave a voicemail. However, you can change it to any of these 9 different options. Call queue would be helpful if you have a lot of incoming calls, but not that many people available to take them. Just choose some users from the team and add them to the queue. While customer is waiting in the call queue, they will hear music on hold that you can upload yourself. The calls are distributed to each available user in sequence, and your customer has a chance to leave a voicemail if you enable play invitation to leave a voicemail every 20 or more seconds. A call to group option gives you an opportunity to set certain users within a team to take calls. Moreover, you can choose the phone ringing sequence for your colleagues sequentially, simultaneously, or round robin. So if I want my sales team to receive the calls all at the same time, I choose team, and then I assign them simultaneous calling method. Add more numbers to your account by going to Numbers in the Web Widget section. Here, you can add, remove, or port in your existing phone number. The porting procedure is completely free and takes for about a week. The support team will be in touch with you during the process. In the meantime, you can just add a temporary number, also for free. Want to see if it's a business call or personal? Just enable caller ID. Also, if you want the name of your business to show up instead of the phone number when making an outbound call, then contact our support team and request a CNAM, which stands for Caller Name Delivery. It's free and works for local numbers only. Another important aspect of our system is your personal settings. You can get there by clicking on the name under the account, my profile, personal details, and it's individual for each user. From there, you can get to my forwarding numbers page. It shows all of your devices if they're enabled or disabled to receive calls, such as MightyCall web phone, your mobile app, your personal cell phone extension, or any SAP desk phones. You can simply enable forwarding by clicking on the Enable button and get connection details. There is also an instruction on how to set up your soft phone or desk phone. Of course, our support team is ready to help you with settings anytime. MightyCall gives you an option to choose how you want your devices to ring, sequentially or simultaneously. In answering roles, you can specify how to distribute calls when you are in the not disturb mode, busy, or when you cannot pick up the phone call. Want to set up your personal voicemail? Go to Greetings and Media section, where you can also change the music on hold and choose a ringback tone. Please note that these are your personal settings, where the call is forwarded to you. Company's general settings are set up in the call flow section. Our mobile app is available for iOS and Android. I'm attaching the links to the App Store and Google Play in the description. With the mobile app, you can make and receive calls, read and send text messages, manage your status, available or do not disturb, add contacts to your contacts book, leave comments, and view communication history, listen and read to your voicemails, as well as call recordings, block unwanted calls. MightyCall's app allows three calling methods. IP telephony is the first, default, and preferred method. It requires a good internet connection. Mixed method, it can be used if your internet connection is not as good. By cell phone, this way your customer will see your personal cell phone number instead of the business one. And this method is used if your internet connection is poor or you don't have one, but still want to make a call. I hope this video was helpful to get you started with MightyCall. In case you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to our support team. They will be able to help. Thank you for watching this video and have a great day.